Historically synonymous with the term labor on the American scene is the name Samuel Gompers, born January 27, 1850. He came as a boy from London to work here, became the first registered member of the Cigar Makers International Union. With other familiar early figures on the trade union scene, rose to prominence as a founder and first president of the American Federation of Labor. John L. Lewis, shown here in youthful close-up, was among the labor pioneers who first gained prominence during the Gompers era. In the March of Labor, he and others before him created milestones, from the Gompers AF-AVL of the 1880s through wars, upheavals, and progress. Samuel Gompers, described as the statesman of labor, would have recognized the statesmanship with which the modern labor leaders, George Meany and Walter Reuther, carried through perhaps the second most notable achievement in all labor's history. Listen.
On behalf of the Joint Labor Unity Committee, I now declare this founding convention of the American Federation of Labor and Congress of Industrial Organizations in order for business.
If the founding of the AF-AVL itself was organized labor's real beginning, this was its new life. The American Federation of Labor and the Congress of Industrial Organizations finally merged in December 1955. Labor's own Capitol building in Washington, the new national headquarters of the AF-AVL-CIO, now welded together into a unit nearly 17 million strong. President Eisenhower attended dedication ceremonies in June of 1956.
Regardless of my tenure in that house across the square, I express this hope that I shall always be as welcome over here as the men on this platform will be over in my office to discuss anything of mutual interest to us both. Labor organizations and government alike must serve the individual and not seek to dominate. People are what count.
Then President George Meany and other officers of the huge labor organization took Mr. Eisenhower on a tour of inspection of the brand new eight-story structure. Decorations upon its inner walls included many reminders of the early struggles and triumphs. Enduring tribute to Samuel Gompers, who died in 1924. Many of the labor laws on today's statute books had their beginning with Gompers. Finally, and so very appropriately, he was behind the law which established Labor Day.